Welcome back to another episode of Tanner Takes. I'm your boy, 18 to 9. I got my usual suspects, Fred the Mouth of the South.
Y'all hate us. I want to tell you that.
Fred, we gave Fred a hard time today, so bear with us. I got our guy Logan back. Hey, welcome back,
yeah,
Logan.
Thanks, man.
He was on vacation last week, man.
We miss you.
Good to be back.
Well, you know,
you
fellas,
come on.
Same old same. I got these takes. I'm going to throw them at y'all.
All right.
Y'all tell me how you feel.
All right. Okay.
You ready?
Let's get started.
All right. My first one, who's the best, who's Washington's top three football players of all time?
All time.
All time.
Ooh,
I know Fred gonna kill me with this. So look, I'm gonna keep it simple. I don't go. I don't think out the box too far.
Yeah.
You know, when I'm rating all time, I'm thinking about guys that's all time in their eras of playing.
Yeah.
All time in their positions.
Sure.
And when you say all time, guy gotta have one of them jackets.
Oh,
you
know what I'm saying?
So here's my guys. I got number one, and these guys they can go in any slot. Number one, I got Art Monk. Art Monk, because, you know, I'm a receiver,
receiver,
so I'm going to give my receivers a little love.
I know he would.
Art Monk, what, 12,000 yards, still has the all-time leading, you know, yard record here.
Yeah.
He's a Hall of Famer. Took a while for him to get in
Super
there.
Super Bowl champion.
Yeah, that's why he's there. Number two, I'm going to give y'all a chance to hear all three of my guys. Number two, I got Darryl Green.
Okay.
20-some years.
Is that you? Would you agree?
All-time leading interception of the team.
Yeah.
All-decade.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, 7-some Pro Bowls.
Yes.
You name it.
Yes. Super Bowl champion.
Darryl Green is that
all.
Guy. Mm-hmm. Last but not least, it might be a surprise to y'all.
Yeah.
I got Riggins.
Riggins is three?
Riggins.
What?
Give I got Riggins.
Some,
I'm going to tell you why. Like I said, like
drinking.
I tell you, he's an all-time guy, too. 9 years, 13,000-some all-purpose yards. He had 11,000 rushing. Do the math. Go look it up. Do the research. So. Riggins was a beast. And at the end of the day, like I said, these guys are all time of their position by any other guy that done came through these doors.
Yeah.
So like it's a slew of guys we could have picked from.
Yeah.
But guess why we call them Tanner Zone. So
that's my take. I'm gonna say that is a fire take.
All right.
Mine's what I really like the addition of Riggins. I know you're gonna hate on that because you don't like running backs.
Yeah, I love Riggins.
I'm a little cold though on there's no quarterbacks on the list.
And
you know why? Cause I was kinda I had Sammy, I had Sonny. My man Sonny, and then
Joe
I had Joe. So and then I had Doug. So I was like, you know what? I'm gonna leave them guys out of there.
But I feel like Sammy Ball or Sonny are like they define an era a little bit, you know, in a way that those other guys don't.
You're absolutely right.
So and like what Sammy Ball you talked about, he's like led the team in touchdowns. Kick return, he was crazy.
Right, first of all, Joe Theismann was the punt returner and also the starting quarterback. Most people don't even know that. Like, I'm a Joe guy. Like, I'm sorry. That thing started out fire.
Yeah.
I'm talking about Miami Heat fire. And then it ended up
with what?
With corn in it. You understand me? He ended up with butane. You understand me? That's how it happened. I'm talking about the first two he fired off there. I'm like, ooh, where he gonna go with this last one? I like, he gotta be Joe Theismann. Might be a little shot.
I knew you weren't gonna like Riggins, though.
No, I
knew you weren't gonna
like Riggins.
And it's not the fact that you don't like Riggins. It's
like
a lot
guy.
Of other
I
players.
But if I had to pick a running back and say, who's the best running back?
I was gonna say Bobby Mitchell. I was gonna say Bobby Mitchell, one of my guys.
Yeah.
But it just, you know, I didn't watch Bobby Mitchell. So I wanted to go with the guys that I watched, the guys that I grew up seeing. And then, like I said before, all time. Every position, every guy I picked.
You know the question with your general Riggins pick? If you had to pick one back, out of the whole history of the Washington team, the best back to ever put these colors on is that John Wiggins.
I think so, right? Well, who would you say?
I think CP is better.
Yeah.
You think CP's better?
I would say Stephen Davis and CP toe-to-toe because I say what they did for the team while they was here, these guys on the same scale. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
CP probably put up better numbers in, you know, a short period of time. But Stephen Davis, man, was undoubtedly like one of the best backs.
Hard. And the one thing Steve and CP do well that I think they did better than Riggo was pass block. And people don't ever want to talk about pass block when it comes
to that. But another reason why I ain't want to put guys that, you know, in our area in there, we ain't win nothing.
We ain't win nothing.
So, you know,
you're
at
right
the end of the day,
that.
Like I said, these guys all time, they got championships, they got jackets, and they still in the top of the books when it comes to all us who came behind them.
Yep.
All right. Next one, fellas. Good job, though.
No, we got to ask us our top three, don't you?
Next. Oh, this is his take.
I was gonna say, man, I got three guys.
Hey, shut up, Fred. Hey, so my next one is, do great wide receivers make a QB or do great QBs make wide receivers? Now, you know I had to take this one, but when I was looking at that, I said, boy, looky here.
This should be hard for this should be hard for you.
I don't care what you got to say.
Yeah.
I'm going with what I got to say, and it's fact. Now, what I would say is great wide receivers overcome mediocre, bad quarterbacks, yeah. mediocre quarterback, average quarterbacks. I've seen plenty of wide receivers be able to put up high numbers with quarterbacks that ain't scratched the surface of being a pro pro bowler or even top 10 in their division. Mm-hmm. Now, 1,000% QBs, great QBs make wide receivers.
Yep. Yeah.
I can go down the list.
Yeah.
And I think a lot of people would say like, oh, well, Tanner, you were really successful.
Yeah.
But you, I think your career would have been better if you played.
If you played with a quarterback for two years,
yeah. No doubt. Yeah. And I say that because when I watch the league, I'm a big football fan.
Yep.
So I watch football day in and day out, and I see the Super Bowls. I see the Tom Brady's. Yep. I see the Mannings. I see the Rodgers.
Yeah.
I see so many guys that they play with, and guys leave them and not be the same guy.
Yeah, yeah.
So and I'm sitting there saying, just give me 2 years with your guy.
Yeah.
You know what mm-hmm. I mean? What if? So. I do believe that wide receivers are able to overcome. They don't make quarterbacks, but a quarterback can make a wide receiver.
I think he's right on the head with this one.
I mean, that's why I got the emojis, Fred, because he's King Fire, right?
Yeah.
And I'm a little sad.
Yeah.
I'm sad for Tana. I'm sad for Terry. Sad for guys that never get to experience that elite guy.
And I appreciate that, but one of the things that I'll never be sad for a guy like myself is because at the end of the day, I went out there and got the job done with who I had.
Yeah.
I didn't make no excuses.
You ain't make no excuses.
No. I would have loved to have the chance to have more, but to be able to walk out of this game highly with my head high and know I still was able to see 10,000 yards, that was a tall task to be asked. And
you know
I went out and got it.
I heart what you said.
Mm-hmm.
I love you so much that I cried. that's all I'm saying. Because it takes a lot for a receiver to say, you know what? I might not be the most important person in this equation.
Yeah.
Because you're looking at your career and you say, you know what? What if I play with Peyton Manning mm-hmm. and not Reggie? What if I play with Ben Roethlisberger? Like, you have to always bring that question
I see
up.
It all the time.
And that's the main reason I did not want to play wide receiver in the league.
It was because of that?
Because I didn't want nobody else to control my destiny.
Because you can't catch the ball.
I can catch a ball.
No, I
wasn't because I ran a 4.9.
But you know how that thing is. If was the fifth, we all would be.
We
so at the end of the day, that's why I don't live on ifs, man.
Yeah.
Good job, though. Next one, fellas. All right. Who's the best running back duo in the league?
Ooh.
This is tough for me, man. Honestly. Because I looked at, last year, the Browns. I felt like Chubb and Hunt.
Yeah.
To me, just those two names alone.
They were the best last year.
What Hunt did before he got to Cleveland and what Chubb was doing while he was there.
Yeah.
Who can say that these guys there's anyone out there better than those two guys?
Yeah.
But then I thought about it. I did a little research. Mm-hmm. And I saw that the Bengals had a guy that was here.
Oh. You're in
P-Rise. And the way he filled in last year when my guy went down.
Joe Mixon.
And mm-hmm. I was like, man, maybe they could be. Then I kept digging. Then I found out that Green Bay Packers had two guys.
I love the buildup there.
Aaron
I love
Jones.
It.
Yeah.
And that big old AJ, Android Dillon.
AJ Dillon.
His style like that.
I call him an Android.
He should work in Kentucky.
He's an Android. These guys combined had 1,800 yards together last year.
Yeah.
So undoubtedly, these guys, to me, should be the best duo. And they were the best duo last year.
Yeah.
And that's what I'm sticking with.
It's fire. I mean, I don't know if there's any another way you could go there and like win that argument because they've been together the longest.
Yeah.
Like I was thinking, like Deontay Foreman and Herbert are probably the best pure runners.
Yeah.
They both rushed for 1,000 yards at different points in their career.
Yeah.
But like they're new. They're a new tandem together, mm-hmm. right? They've done it. AJ Dillon, what he does in the pass, not AJ Dillon, Jones, what he does in the pass game is so special. So I don't know how you go a different direction there.
Well, I can.
Because you're cool.
I'm cool with it. I'm cool with what you said.
Now tell me this though. Because I want to hear y'all take on this one. How do you feel our running back duo slot in with all those guys that I mentioned?
I think we got somebody for each job. And that's what you want your backfield to consist of. I got my power guy that's going to bend you to his wheel with B-Rob. I got my Ace of Spades that I can move anywhere when I'm talking about Gibson. And then I got Chris Rodriguez that's coming in and keep giving you headaches, making sure you got to take aspirin into the fourth quarter. So I just think we got guys. And then don't forget, add Curtis Samuel to that running set, that group, and not as full versatility.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, who are you going to say, though? You were going to say someone before that.
I was going to say, here go the future of the NFL, the Atlanta Falcons. Bijan Robinson.
Okay.
And they got Aguilar last year.
Algier.
I butchered that. And they also had Cordarrelle Patterson.
Yeah.
All right, so
Patterson is a man.
And I feel like
a wrecking crew by itself.
So, and I feel like Bijan is super wide out. Yeah. Like he gonna be a better wide out than people think he is.
Yeah.
Then you got this guy, like it's something going down there with Arthur Smith in Atlanta.
And I will say the thing about Jones and Patterson that separates them from our group is we haven't seen Gibson be that elite receiver.
Exactly.
I know you think he can do it.
Yeah.
I know you think he can do it. I'm excited to see if he can get it done.
Yeah.
Like that's the thing that differentiates those top tier groups, right?
And then the thing about that also, we haven't seen that, but he still was phenomenal last year at that small, you know.
Dosage that he had.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Last year, we saw him play with a chip. You know what I mean? We saw him go out there and like, man, I'm almost off this team. So let me show these guys until this other guy come back. You know, I can go out there and carry the load. So, hey, we're going to be looking forward to seeing some more of them.
Yep,
you know?
Yep.
All right, good job for the next one. Who's your top musician? Top musician.
Now,
this is something that me and Fred probably going, you know, we can go head to head with, but I'm one of those guys. I got two sides. I'm straddling the fence when it comes to R&B, rap, but I had to choose one.
Yeah.
So I choose one. I did that.
Well, Beyonce?
My top, no. Oh, all right. My top musician was Tupac.
Okay.
Oh, this is all time or now?
This
is his take, man. Come on, let him.
I'm asking. I need to be clear.
Yeah, you know, see, he forgets it's my show. I tried to get him off this show, too, so matter of fact. But,
I'm the rogue. I ain't never going nowhere.
I would say Tupac, and I say Tupac for many reasons.
Yeah.
One, for a reason that Fred probably know I'm going to bring up. He speaks my language. He's a Gemini.
Yeah. Oh, Gemini. Here we go, baby. Madam Cleo in this thing.
We speak the same language, man. You know, some guys, I mean, if you ever met a Gemini, if you ever meet any Geminis out there, you might meet them and they might be one way and then they're another way. He can do it all. He can get in front of the camera and play in some of your top moves.
Oh, yes.
He can get behind that mic and go out there and be a lyricist. And then more than anything, he was basically showing us firsthand what we was going through in this country. You know, some of the things that we still fight for today.
Yeah.
I don't put all that into the category of being a musician, though, but at the same time, I think when it comes to what I was looking at to fulfill that slot, he felt that spot because he did all those things. So.
I want to know who your favorite is. Who you got, Three Doors Down or somebody?
Backstreet Boys?
Backstreet Boys?
NSYNC, maybe? no, I don't really listen to, like, this is going to be a surprise. I don't listen to music like that. I do like Tupac because it's on in the locker room. I like what he does, but... Yeah. Not a big music guy.
I'm more non-violent in my music loving.
Well, first off, Tana, fire take. I was sad that you brought up the Gemini thing because I was with you, but then it just got all crazy.
They don't like us Geminis, man.
Oh, I like that too.
Marvin Gaye. See, I like my music to bring
DMV too, right?
He just soulful. And I like the people that bring people together. But I also like you to tell a story. I don't want you to sell me music just because you're telling it. I want you to sell me music that changes something. And Marvin Gaye, take it to us too early. I thought was the greatest artist of all time, Marvin.
Well, I appreciate you guys. And you got to understand something. We still in the month of June, baby. It's Gemini season. You know what I'm talking about, my Geminis, man. That's it for Tana Takes, man. See you next week.